Assalamualaikum and good morning students. It's biology for class 10 and the topic is going on control and coordination. In your previous class, you have studied about the structure of neuron and the function of the different parts of neuron. In today's class, you are going to study about the nervous system. Nervous system and endocrine system are the two systems which works in our body to control and coordinate the different parts of body. And nervous system, we can divide it into two main categories. Nervous system, that is central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system, you can understand this is in the center, and peripheral means around it. So central nervous system, further we can divide into two main organs or two main parts. The first one is brain and the second one is spinal cord. And peripheral nervous system, which consists all the different type of neurons, it further divide into two categories: autonomous nervous system and somatic nervous system. So got you student this chart? Nervous system divide into two categories or two parts: central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Further, the central nervous system divided into two parts: brain and spinal cord. Then peripheral nervous system, which consists all the nerves, it has further divided into two parts: autonomous nervous system and somatic nervous system. About the different all this component you will study in the subsequent classes. Now the part of the central nervous system, that is the brain. Brain is the main organ of the nervous system. It is the largest organ of the nervous system and it's a very important organ of our body. Why very important? As it controls the activity of the all the different organs of the body. So we can say the brain is the master of the body. Now where the brain is located, what are the main functions of the different parts of the brain that we will study. First, the brain. The location of the brain, it is located in our head. And as I told you, it is a very important organ. So it is protected also. It is protected by the part of skeletal system, that is skull. The bone of skull, which does not have any joints, okay, as it is very important organ. So there are no joints in the bones of the skulls, clear? And it is the very hard bones, hardest bone we can say here, and they are protecting the brain below the skull. So the part of skeletal system, skull, is protecting the brain. Below the skull, there are the three layers of membrane. Three layers of membranes are there. And these layers of membrane, three membranes, are called meninges. Clear? Between these meninges, there is a fluid present in it. The fluid. And the fluid is known as cerebrospinal fluid. Cerebrospinal fluid. Understood, student? So as the brain is a very important part, it is a part of nervous system. It controls and coordinate the activities of the different parts of the body. So the protection of brain is required, and the brain is protected by skull. It is protected by the three membranes. The name of membranes is meninges. It is also called meninges. And between these meninges. There is a fluid present which is called cerebrospinal fluid, and all this prevent the brain from the mechanical injury. Clear? Now come to the parts of the brain. A human brain mainly divide into the three main parts. First one is forebrain. This you can see the largest. This is the largest part. It is forebrain. So the first part is forebrain. This is second one is midbrain. Okay, and the third one is hindbrain. Hindbrain means the last. Fore means aage, mid means in between, and hindbrain means at the last. Okay, so brain is divided into the three main parts. Clear? Now the parts of forebrain. As I told you, brain divided into forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. Now come to the forebrain. Forebrain is the largest part of the brain. Okay, it is the largest part of the brain. And further, it is divided into the three parts: cerebrum, diencephalon, and hypothalamus. Today I will explain you about the cerebrum. This you can see the cerebrum. Okay, cerebrum is the largest part of the forebrain. I told you, forebrain is the largest part of the brain, and cerebrum is the largest part of the forebrain. Clear? And this cerebrum consists four lobes. There are the different lobes has been given. You can see here. The first lobe is frontal lobe. This one is frontal. Parietal lobe, occipital lobe, and temporal lobe. Clear? Frontal lobe. In our body, there are the different type of involuntary actions are going on. There are voluntary actions and involuntary actions. So, the frontal lobe, the function is, it controls the movement. It controls the moment. It controls the thinking process. It controls the thinking, means the thinking process is going on in the frontal lobe. The decision making, like you want to do something, which part of your brain helps you to make that decision? Yes, today I have to study maths. Okay, you make one decision. So that decision has been taken by your frontal lobe. Understood? Movement. You are walking. You are taking your hand up and down. You are nodding your head. This all type of movement is controlled by the frontal lobe. Second one is coming. That is parietal lobe. As I told you, the five sense organs are there. So the parietal lobe is receiving and processing the sensory information. Clear? Next is coming sensory information related to the sight, related to the touch, related to the temperature. These all receiving and processing work has been done by the part of the brain, that is forebrain, and in forebrain cerebrum, and in cerebrum the lobe is there, that is parietal lobe. Clear? Next is coming occipital. Occipital controls all the visual information, means what we can see. It is all what is in front of you. Like I have drawn the three lines, you can see it is being processed by the occipital lobe. Then the last one is there, that is temporal lobe. Temporal lobe, like I'm speaking, you are able to listen my sound. So speech production is controlled by temporal lobe. So students, today I have completed the topic cerebrum. द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रेन एंड द फंक्शन आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू इन द नेक्स्ट क्लासेस. हैव अ नाइस डे अहेड.